Hi traders, market's gapping down today. And there's a lot of candidates. One of them is JWN, which is down more than 8%. And look at this beautiful reversal over here. Now, as you can see, the first green candle is up, and very nice green candle. And then a red candle tried to move higher, failed. Now it's coming down again. I'm getting ready to short 4,000 shares. Here we go. Now I'm short. Just moved under 34.50, looks like a nice reversal point, and it should continue from here. Qualcomm also looking very good for a short. I'm a bit worried about Qualcomm because Qualcomm is a big company and a lot of people love to buy it when it's down, although it's down 10% right now. I am interested in shorting it, and I will short it right at 70.10 approximately now. I'm short 2,000 shares. The reason I'm taking smaller size in Qualcomm is not because it's a big mover, it's because I'm concerned. Again, people love to buy it when it's down. Smaller size for me. VFC. It's all over the place, up and down, but end game is 5% down right now. I'm going to short 2,000 shares. If it comes down under this support line over here, I want to see it under the view up and under this support, and it's just about to get there, and I'm short. I'm short now, short at 87.12. This initially looks like a very interesting down move. I hope it's going to continue. URBN is trending lower very quickly, very clearly. Stock is down 7%, and I think it's getting ready to move to a new low, although I'm a bit worried about the $25 whole number. The recent low is 25.06, and I want to short it before that. Shorting now. I'm short 4,000 shares. It's not a big risk in URBN. And I need to see it under the lows, which is $25, and I'm a bit concerned about the $25 whole number. JWN is doing good, just moved to a new low. It's slowly trending lower. Stock's already down almost 11%. I'm about to take my partial 3,600 shares. In any sign of bullish, watch the buyers. Watch the buyers now. I saw the buyers moving up like 6-7 cents, and that for me is the first sign of a pullback. I've done well in JWN. That's my first trade and my first winner today. Qualcomm isn't going anywhere. I'm green like 20 cents by now, but I want to reduce my size, reducing now. I reduced 1,000 shares now. Earlier I had 2,000 shares for a short. When the stock is not going your way, there's no reason to hold. It doesn't matter if you're up or down. Even if you're up, you should be moving out because it's not going the way you expected it to go, and I'm out. VFC, same story. In this case, I'm red and I'm going to reduce size. But more dramatically, I'm going to reduce 1,400 shares, and unlike Qualcomm, it's going to be at a loss. Now, I'm reducing at a loss VFC. And again, I reduced in Qualcomm. I did not go out. I reduced my size, and now I'm reducing VFC while I'm down at VFC. AMBA was one of my candidates for the day, and I'm about to short it as it comes down now under this support level here. About to short, shorting now 2,000 shares. Now, AMBA is very interesting because it's down 10%. With the same technical formation, I wouldn't have short a different stock, but AMBA is down 10%, it should come down. Well, sadly, as expected, Qualcomm's not going my way. I'm still green, so I'm going to reduce my size here. Actually, closing it now. I close Qualcomm now, and I'm out of Qualcomm, and I'm green because I don't trust it to continue lower. And again, stock is not doing what I expected it to do. I'm out, although I'm green. AMBA is doing great. And again, any sign of a pullback now, I'm going to take a partial of 1,800 shares. I'm short 2,000. I'm going to cover 1,800 at any sign of pullback. And again, watch the sellers, and they just moved up by 10 cents or so, and I click the button. So I've got my partial in AMBA, and it's looking good for continuation. I'm holding 200 shares. Well, VIFS is not doing good. I reduced my size earlier, 1400 shares, and I'm about to reduce the last 600 if it's going to move over 70, and it just did. It just did. I'm closing it. Well, same story as Qualcomm. Qualcomm, I closed at a profit, a small profit. VFC, I'm closing, as you can see here, at a loss of $780. Tesla is very interesting. Wanted to short it earlier under 200.60, and it's getting close right now. Now, as you can see, it failed to move higher, which is great. Now it's coming back down, and I'm getting ready to short it at my planned entry, which is now. I'm short. Very small size. I'm not taking a risk. I'm nicely green for the day so far. So just 400 shares. It's a huge mover. It could be a 2-point stop loss, anywhere between 1.5 and 2 point stop loss, but it looks great now for a short. It's failing. URBN didn't yet break down under the lows. It's touching the lows again now. It did move under 25, which is great, but didn't make the big move maybe now. Okay, that looks good. That looks good. That looks good. That looks better. Great. That's the move I was looking for. Getting ready to cover 3,600 shares. At any sign of a pullback? At any sign of a pullback? Watch the sellers again. Watch the sellers. Here we go. Moving up a bit. Clicking the button. They just moved up from 2480 to 2485. And I clicked the button. Took my partial in URBN. And that one turned out to be a very nice winner too. And look at this spike up. It just touched the lows. And look at how it spikes up. And you want to see why? Well, the reason is not URBN. The reason is the S&P 500. Look at what happened. Look at this spike up at the S&P 500. This is a huge spike. And I just learned that Donald Trump just tweeted something. I don't care what, but he tweeted something. And look at how the market spiked up. You don't move out on spikes. Never move up on out of spikes. If you've seen my videos, I've discussed it so many times. Now, look at the right side here. This is Tesla. Tesla looked like it's going to be a winner, and it spiked up with the market. Everything is spiking up. You watch URBN now spiking up after I took the partial. Now, look at the S&P when it spiked up, same timing. Look at Tesla when it spiked up, same timing. But usually, spikes don't last. So Tesla spiked up, but there's bad news in Tesla. Everybody sees the stock coming down to $10 up to $30. It's at 200 now. So stay with the stock. Don't be scared away. And look at Tesla. Came down under support, and I've got a fantastic winner right now. Only 400 shares, but what a lovely trade. Shorted it at 200.60. just below, and I've got more than a point now. I'm getting ready for my partial. Took my partial. Well, I thought I'm going to take my partial a little bit lower than that, and I still think it can go, but you know, it's my last open trade today, and really wanted to put this one behind me, and that was a beautiful move. And again, you never move out on spikes. Tesla did move out on a spike with the market, but never did anything wrong. Came down, I have my partial. That's a great trade in Tesla. And here's how I'm doing today. I've got five winners: AMBA, JWN, Qualcomm, Tesla, URBN. Qualcomm, of course, very, very small winner. And look at my loser. One loser at VFC after reducing my size. Keep your loser small. Up $3,700. It's a great day and just over an hour. Thank you for watching. Thank you for watching our video. Before you go, we invite you to join the TradeNet Trading Room for a free 14-day trial. TradeNet has educated more than 30,000 professional traders worldwide since 2004, and its Trading Room is one of the world's leading trading communities. Click here to start your free trial. If you like this video, please subscribe to our YouTube channel where you can view many more stock trading videos. Questions or comments, please submit them below.